Hello to all of our BPTV friends, YouTube friends, Facebook friends, and new friends with the great guests we have coming up. I'm Alan Levine, the Talking Machine, and we're doing another Maria's Ideas Teaches Us to Paint show. Co-host, co-producer, Maria is going to tell us what's going on for today, and it's something that's heartfelt with me. So, Maria, how are you?
I'm good, Alan. Thank you so much. Thank you guys for being here. We're really happy today to kick this off. And we're at Jono's, our studio in the Southside Slope. So, if you're ever in the area, you could stop by. So, this design was inspired by one of our cameramen, Nick, who loves baseball. So, he suggested the baseball. So, I designed it, and Alan came up with the name Out of the Park. So we're painting Out of the Park.
Well, I used to pitch, and I never wanted them to hit it out of the park.
Okay.
They couldn't hit home runs off me. I was so good. I love baseball more than Nick does to this day.
Okay. And we're so happy to have our friend, Executive Director of Bethel Park Public Library, Christine McIntosh. Great person. If you ever go to the library, stop and say hi to Christine. She does awesome things there.
Well, thank you. It's good to be here.
Yeah,
I'm happy to be here.
Thanks. So. Yeah.
And viewers see me on other.
Yeah, she's out there. So, but she's going to paint today.
Which should be very interesting because I don't paint.
Good. But you will today.
Okay. I'm looking forward to it.
You'll do a great job.
Christine, you know we're friends.
Yes.
I asked Maria to do this show.
Yes.
And she said I had to be on. I said I haven't painted in like 50 some years because I'm that old. She goes, Al, I'll teach you.
That's what I'm here for.
I'm doing my eighth show. She's taught me. Yep. And she compliments me because she's my teacher. She doesn't want me to look bad that she's teaching.
No, you're good. Everybody can learn. Anybody can learn. It's easy. So let's get started. So we are going to paint this. So we have our design. I have the printout. We have the design over top. We're using 11 by 14 canvas panels. You can use a canvas, stretch canvas. We're using the panels because they don't bounce. I don't like the bounce so much on the camera. So we're just going to lift it up, and
we have
graphite transfer paper. There's one side is shiny, so shiny side down. And just put it, I would do like, you know, half of the design because it's not as big as the paper.
Here's what she taught me, Kristen.
Yeah.
Okay. Beautiful.
Okay. There you go. And then we'll just take your pen, and then we'll transfer. You don't have to press really hard because it does transfer pretty easily.
Okay.
But for this circle... Oh, he's doing it freehand.
I'm not doing it freehand.
Oh, no, he was just doing the stripes.
Yeah, so, you know why? I'm getting ready because
you
taught me, teacher, how to stage stuff.
Okay.
I'll wait for that device that you came up with.
So,
wait till you hear this story.
Well, I wanted a really nice circle for the baseball, even though we have to paint it, you know, freehand. So I was running around my house last night, and I found an old-fashioned sewing kit lid that was the exact same size and then a little handle. So I'm just going to do mine. I'm just going to lay it down here, and then I'll pass it on to you guys. And this way, you could probably use like a little dessert dish or a lid for something. And as simple as that, I just traced around. I'm gonna lift it up, make sure. Yep, so you can see, it's a perfect circle. There you go. So you can just lay that down, okay. And then just obviously keep it in place as you get that around there. And then I'm going to draw the little lace, the lines for the, is that the laces? Would it be laces?
Like on a baseball, it's laces.
It's called laces. The little
stitching,
and then I'm going to turn my transfer paper to make sure I get all the buildings.
And so notice how I waited for you guys to do that.
Did. So we're going to do this now. And this is just the just a little hint of our awesome, beautiful skyline here in Pittsburgh. If you've ever been to PNC Park, it is the most beautiful ballpark.
It is.
The skyline and the river and the lights, and it's just very pretty. So that, and then these, again, this is just the wall and the hint of the field.
This is a great device. This is unreal.
Yeah, it's perfect.
This is so easy.
I'll set it up here. One of my flea market finds. And it's like a little sewing kit thing.
And you are the queen And Jono's the king of repurposing everything.
I love to do that.
I appreciate what you're doing.
I grew up with people doing that, my grandparents. And
well, you're
being
honoring,
resourceful and creative.
You're honoring
you
their spirit here.
Did you have the metal cookie tin full of buttons and other tchotchkes?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I still do.
My grandma died 25 years ago.
Okay.
And my aunt still lives in the house.
Aww.
And I asked her about it, and she said she... Yeah, well, she accidentally dropped it down the cellar steps, and all the buttons went everywhere, but yes.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah. Yep, we had that. All those good things. But I make a lot of things with found objects and vintage things, so I definitely have my tins of buttons. All right, so I made sure, so the lines for the field, so we have art kits. You can get the art kit from us, but I do include a list of everything on the our YouTube channel, which is Maria's Ideas Art. That's where I have the extra, a second video that goes with every episode, which is a 10-minute video that shows you how to draw this on your own if you need help with that. Otherwise, you can just, I have the material list on every description as well.
And I've watched them, so pay attention to it. She helps you with the questions I have and others,
yeah.
And look how she's helped me, and I'm enjoying it.
Everyone can learn. I mean, it's not that difficult to learn. I think a lot of people are afraid that it's more complicated, but it really isn't. It's just step by step, just the process with anything you would create or make or do. It's just you start with the basic.
I agree.
You build a house, you know, you start with the foundation. Same thing with the artwork. So that's it. So I have mine. And the little people, we are going to do those freehand. So you don't have to draw the players. But I have no idea, like who they are or what position. You can help me with that.
Well, I don't know a lot of them either.
Oh.
They brought them up from the minor leagues, and it's hard to follow who's here and who's going.
I mean, like, where they are on the field.
Oh, I can do catcher, pitcher, first base, second, shortstop, third base, right field, left field, center. Yeah, I can do that.
Okay, all right. Now I get to put this back.
Oh, I got to catch up and quit talking.
Yeah.
Imagine that.
Oh, welcome to the show.
That's why it's called Olivine the Talking Machine. All right. Oh, righty. All right, so I'm going to get started, and I'll just keep moving along. I'll help you, but you can keep painting, and I'll make sure that you're
okay
good with everything. All right, so we are going to start with the background. And usually I start up at the top and work on my way down. But because the sky is brighter, usually the sky's brighter at the horizon line, whether it's a sunrise or sunset. So we're going to start here because we're going to start with white and introduce the blue on our brush and just kind of keep it moving. You don't even have to waste time cleaning brushes or changing brushes. So we're going to start with the lighter color and then just do that sky and clouds, and we'll just do this in little sections. So it's kind of like paint by number without the numbers.
That's the only thing I've done. I had a
paint by number?
Yeah, a great photo. Well, there's some services now where you can take a photo and they'll make it into a paint by number.
Yeah.
So I painted a picture of my nephew's chocolate lab.
Aww,
wow, that's so cool.
It was so much fun.
So you can do this then. So look, it's the same, just without the numbers.
Yes.
So we are going to start with our half-inch flat brush. Yep.
Okay.
And then I like to dip it in the water and then take the extra water off. Sometimes they have a little, like a glue in there that keeps the bristles in shape if it's a new brush. And then I like to shape it like that. Just take that extra water and always make sure the bristles, you know, are where they, the direction they need to go.
Okay.
So we are going to start down here. So I'm taking white, a generous amount of white, and I'm going to put that on my palette here. And then I'm going to, because I want a little bit of the, I don't want it solid white, I just want a hint of the blue at the base. And then I'm taking the corner of the brush and just going into just a little part of the little paint pot. And I'll put that blue beside it, so that way you can introduce the blue a little bit at a time. So I already feel like that's too much, so I'm going to take some of that extra off. Basically just kind of want a little bit of a dirty white with the little hint of the blue. So I'm coming in.
So just a little touch of the blue then in there?
Very little bit. So you can just put the blue beside it and then bring it in. So if you look at this close, you can see it's not stark white. It has a hint of the blue. And then I'm just coming in, and because this brush is square, you can, or a rectangle, you can see if you lay it down in between the buildings, if I turn it sideways, that fills in that space nicely. So I'm just filling this in, and I'm moving my brush around in different directions because this is a sky. There might be some clouds in the sky, or it actually might look a little nicer if you have the brush strokes in different directions. So I'm just pulling this in, adding a tiny bit of blue as I need it. If you go over the lines a little right here, you can see I did purposely. That's okay, I can still see them through there. But you wanna make sure when you cut in, you definitely get close to the buildings so there's no gap there in the bare canvas. So that's very pale. I don't even know if it shows
mine's
that much.
Too blue. I went too heavy.
Well, that's
handed.
Okay. Just now, just
I'm lightening it
up. Take the extra paint off on your paper towel.
Yeah.
And then just add white to your brush.
I just did. Yeah.
Yep. But then don't put it back on. Yeah. Just and you can just blend it because you really need it light at the bottom so that it makes it interesting, like the sun is maybe.
I know you
would
taught
be
me
a
with
nice
shadows.
Game?
Yeah. Yeah. It so could
you,
be.
Yeah. You can just throw some
well,
white on
there. Well,
at
dusk, it's one of the most beautiful parks mm-hmm. at dusk.
Yeah, it is. And we could have added some warm colors to this, but I thought, nah, I'm going to stick with just a blue, crisp blue sky like we have here. And actually today we have lime like that. And I wanted that ball to just really pop on that blue sky. So now as this is still wet, I'm coming in with, just going to move that over
yeah,
a little bit.
Sorry.
I'm coming in with a little bit light. You can see I add a little bit of blue. And now I'm going to, just where they transition, it might be just a little bit, but I'm going to push it around. You can see how messy that looks, but I'm taking the extra off and adding a little white, but I want them to blend. And the key to that is just doing that while they're wet. So I just took some more extra paint off and I'm just kind of pushing that around just where they meet. And then I'll get into that darker.
Thanks for your
blue.
Tips.
Yeah, see how they just, and they're, I'm by pushing it around like that, in different directions. You can see I'm flipping the brush even different directions mm-hmm. like that. That just kind of gives it more of a cloud-like feel. And now I'm coming in really intense blue around the
where
ball
the baseball.
Because I want that to show up. Now, to cut in around the baseball nicely and not have it look like you know, a piece of popcorn because it's so lumpy. popcorn's not a bad thing when it comes to baseball, though. But so what I'm doing is you can lay your brush down this way if you choose, and see how I'm resting the brush on the canvas, and you can let that front bristle and just pull it around.
It's like cutting in a wall when you're painting.
Yeah, exactly, but you can do it that way, but I feel like I have more control. I have the brush loaded, a generous amount of paint. I take the extra paint off on the palette. And now I'm coming in, if you do it this way, see, Christine, if you lay it, see that corner?
Yes.
And now let it, see how it's resting on there?
Yes.
In that the edge of the bristles there, and then same thing, you just pull it around.
Okay.
And that's how you cut in around, and you want to find that where you can see, I feel like there's enough paint on there. If there's not enough, it's just going to drag, and then it'll look, it just won't, you won't cover up the canvas as much. So you can see that cuts in right around there. But before I start cutting in all the way around the ball, I need to move this paint while it's wet because this is acrylic, so it dries really quickly. So you can see, while I just did that, I'm going to move it around, take that extra paint off, and just that way if it's wet, you can see it'll just blend really nicely. And then just kind of keep moving it around. If it gets too blue, you just add a little bit of white. You don't have to clean. You don't have to rinse the brush. You can take some of the extra paint off on the paper towel. And if yours is a little bluer or lighter, it's
mine
fine.
Is a lot bluer. I'm trying my best.
No, that's good. It doesn't have to look like mine. This is your sky, right? You can do whatever you want. So I'm just, you can see I just laid the brush down and I'm just pulling it around. And when I do the skies like this, I'm basically just cleaning off my brush. You can see I'm just kind of cleaning off my brush.
Wow.
Get that extra paint off and then go back in with the dark. But where these transition, that's where I like them to blend a little. So the blue and the lighter blue here, I just added a little bit of white and then kind of pushed it back into both areas. And then over here, I think I want, ooh, that's a little dark there. I think I want a cloud, a lighter cloud. So I'm just going to add a lot of white to my brush and just kind of push that around. And as the
she's going advanced on us.
Oh, I know.
And this is one of those things, though. It's like kind of the faster you work, the more natural it may tend to look because you're not thinking about it too much. You're just pushing that paint around.
Uh-oh, we could have trouble here then.
Yeah. And that's good. So now this, you can see it, it really blended in, but as it dries, I will add more white because it's, when it's wet, it's only going to get as white as the combination when they mix. So I'll let that dry a little, and then I'll come back to it and add a little bit more white. And this blue is a little bit darker than the blue in the design, but that's okay. But I want it really dark at the top. And then that makes the lighter area seem even lighter.
Should I add a little white before I do the bottom of the ball, or just try it?
That's okay if you like it like that, but just make sure you get really dark up top. If you want to, you could add a little white closer to the buildings maybe. So you can see here, if I go like this, there's definitely not enough paint. If you get that dry brush look, you just have to load more paint on your brush, that's all. You could add a little bit of water too, but if you add water, it could tend to pick up the paint and like remove it from the canvas. So this, for the technique that we're using here, it's better to just add more paint. And you could see the ball is not like perfectly round with my cutting in, but I'll fix that whenever. Well, at least I hope to, right? We're going to do it freehand. We could always make
a stencil. We have a good teacher. Just follow along.
I mean, you could always make a like a template or a stencil, I guess, if you wanted to. But we're just going to do it freehand. And so now you could see here where it's very, very dark and then into light. Now I just added white because that white will mix with the wet blue. See how it's, if it's still wet, you have a better, it's just easier to blend. And then I feel like if I keep going, now that's going to add too much blue. So I'm just taking the extra paint off, and then I'll move it around. So it's just a matter of kind of going back in, adding more of the dark, more of the light, wherever you feel like you need it. And I feel like this might need to be a little bit.
And thanks for explaining that as you're going here.
Yeah, sure.
It's helping me.
Yeah. So do you have any great baseball memories, you guys?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Okay. How about how I became a pitcher? I'm 11 years old. I'm in the outfield. It's the last game of the season.
Okay.
I'm in center field. I caught the ball, and a guy tagged up. I threw him out at home plate, threw the ball on a fly.
Okay.
So after the game, I was a shy kid, and the coach goes,
I find that hard to believe.
Uh-huh.
I truly was. So the coach goes, hey, Alan, that was a heck of a throw. I go, oh, thanks. He goes, did you ever think of being a pitcher? I go, no. He goes, would you want to be a pitcher? I go, I don't know. And I didn't ask questions or anything. He goes, could anybody in your family help you? And I go, my cousin's a pitcher, and my dad's a sports guy. He could help, and he's helping us. He goes, would you try it? I go, yes. So needless to say, my cousin, after hours and hours of practice, days and everything else, I started my 12-year-old last year of Little League as a pitcher.
Okay.
First game. I strike out about 8 or 9 guys.
Oh, wow.
I win the game, you know, by a couple runs.
Yeah.
And during the season, I had 2 no-hitters. I was 7-1. I cried when we lost the game. And I averaged striking out 2 guys per inning.
Wow.
And we ended up being co-champs because we lost that one game.
Wow.
So
you never know unless you try something, right?
Well, look at me not even asking, what do I do? So
that's awesome. How about you, Christine?
I played softball.
Did you?
Nice. I played softball for years.
And what position did you play?
I played center field, and I was also cleanup batter because I had a hell
Doesn't
of a bat.
John Mellencamp have a center
cleanup
field
batter?
Song?
Yeah. What does that mean?
That's a good hitter.
Yeah.
Home run hitter.
I was fourth in the lineup. I had a walk-off grand slam.
Whoa.
Of the only game my mother ever missed because she had to work, and she was so mad because my dad was always working. So
we didn't videotape everything back then.
I have baseball trivia for you on the only major leaguer to have a walk-off grand slam home run in the major leagues.
Yeah.
And he's from Pittsburgh.
Oh.
He was up here with the Pirates, Roberto Clemente.
Oh, uh-huh.
He hit the ball deep in the center field. You know how big center field was, so they're fooling around with it. Three guys scored. Now Roberto's running. You know he could fly. His hands, his legs. He goes past first and the second, keeps going. He's running the third. The coach puts up his hands, hold up. He's yelling at him to stop. Roberto ignores him, runs around third base, goes home and gets the first ever, nobody's done it since in the 50s, yeah, walk-off grand slam at Forbes Field.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
It's the only one ever, so you did what he did couple of years later.
Yes.
That's awesome. Yes. Girl power. So this was the perfect design for you then.
Yes. No, I like it.
We're tying in with all this stuff.
This is beautiful.
I played, oh, thank you.
I do. I love it.
I played, yeah, I loved it. I played softball until I was 18 and then they had to pay for the bar league, and then I quit. But I could still, we go to the batting cages. My husband and I.
You do well still? You got a good eye.
I do. Still, believe it or not, but it hurts more.
We're not asking their age, and I don't care. I never ask women their ages.
No,
so
I
feel it the next day, maybe a little bit.
Yeah, and this last time, Bill's like, well, let's see if you can hit a baseball. We'll just put it on slow.
Yeah.
And I was able. I was
That's
able.
Awesome. Well, so. Then this is great. That's good.
Yeah, so. What a tie-in. Who knew with Christine?
I know, for
that's
real.
Great. That looks really good. I love how you, I just, yeah.
Well, I'm not so crisp around the ball, but.
No, don't worry about that. Mine isn't either. See, it's just, we clean that up when we paint it.
Mine looks like it's crisp. It's a little
variable.
Yeah,
no, it looks good.
It's a little variable.
It's going to be a little tricky.
Great story, though, Christine.
Yeah.
Maria, thanks for bringing that out. You know you had to pry me to talk now.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, please.
Because you're so shy.
Yeah.
My reputation precedes me.
Believe it or not, I used to be very shy.
I was too.
Were
I
you?
Was the.
I and look, we're all like talking. And
I was.
Well,
the,
my dad was the life of the party wherever you go, and me and my sister, 14 months younger than me, Joy, we would never talk. And then my younger sisters, they were like 3 and 5 years younger. They would talk a little bit, but I wouldn't till I became a teenager and played sports. It gave me confidence, and I always thought when I was shy that I wanted to be like Abraham Lincoln because he had the same nickname or initials like me, A.L., and Mark Twain. Those were my two role models.
I thought maybe because you wanted to wear a big funny hat.
No. I don't even wear hats, just baseball hats.
Okay.
But I wanted to be like him because of how he talked and what he did for the country. And you know, how he played sports. You know he was the greatest wrestler in the country.
Oh, okay.
He would take all challengers, and he'd beat them. And then they always think a big, tall guy like that had a real deep voice. He had a high-pitched voice. In today's world, they'd be like, what are we listening to?
That's funny.
And look at how great he was, so that's what I found out.
Interesting.
And then Mark Twain, you know, that was my hero, reading Huckleberry Finn and his stories. And then he worked for newspapers, so as I was 18, 19, I did too.
Yeah.
He was an editor, only I was a production marker.
Oh.
So that's who I wanted to be.
Interesting.
And that's how I learned
to
talk.
We're glad you're you. We don't, you know.
Well, thank you.
We already had one of them, so we're good. So.
I had to work hard at it to get this way.
All right. So I'm done with my sky. And now you can see I added a couple little clouds. I added one up in the left corner, just to add a little interest up in there. And I just mix the blue and the white. I still feel like I might add a little bit more white after this dries, like right just kind of in here. The little birds we'll add later. So I'm gonna let that dry.
Oh, we're gonna put birds in too.
Oh yes.
I used to color, I used to like making birds.
Yep, you can do that. That's how we're doing these. So
we used to make the crows flying.
There you go. So I'm going to, I'm just throwing in a little bit more white right in here. And you can always do that after we get the buildings done, but. All right, so I am working on the buildings. I'm going to still use the same brush, the half inch, and then we will also alternate with, I have a little quarter inch flat brush that's a new one. Ooh, it's like crunchy. All right, because these two brushes are the sizes of my buildings. Now what we're going to do for the buildings.
And that's a quarter inch flat?
Yeah, so I'm gonna use
like
both.
This?
Yes.
Okay, just checking. Yeah. You know I'm learning. I've learned a couple things. Yeah. Thank you, Maria.
So you can see the buildings here are, I have them in shades of gray and blue. So I'm just mixing various tones. I'll outline, I'm probably gonna just paint in the buildings first with a solid color, and then I'll come in and hit them with just some other tones. I don't want them to be all gray. I don't want it to be all blue. I just want to mix. So I'm taking some white.
You better explain what you're doing now.
I will, yeah.
All right.
So white, a little bit of blue, and a little bit of black. So I'm triple loading my brush. I'm putting some white, some blue, and some black, and then we'll see how that comes up.
Yeah. First for our show, triple loading. I've never heard of it before.
So you'll see whenever, kind of like when I'm loading the bases, I'm loading the brush.
Yes, first, second, and third.
Yes. So when I lay my brush down vertically at the edge of that building, you can see that's just the shape of the building. And if it's a little bit bigger than what we drew, that's okay too. And by loading the brush that way, you can see I have all the variations in there already. So I actually like the way that looks. So if we keep it, I did the white first, and then I added a little blue just on the corner, and then a little black. So when I pull that down, I just have, it's darker on the left side than on the right. And again, it doesn't all have to match, like everything the same. Now this one, I'm just using blue and white, and I'm just pulling vertically, simple shapes, and then you can turn the brush horizontally also, just to clean up those lines, and even the ones that I drew, they're not perfectly straight. And you can see obviously that this, the buildings and the field is angled. Why? I don't know. I just wanted to add a little more interest instead of it being the perfectly horizontal image of the field. And I figured it's kind of like more about the ball, you know, and the perspective from the ball. So I just did it that way.
Our focus is on that big baseball. Yeah, you did well.
So I'm just kind of, so you could see that I'm just mixing the colors, kind of even on the canvas too, just mixing them. Some of the buildings are bluer, some are grayer, some are a little lighter, and that just helps them define, it helps you define the different shapes. And I can even, I think it looks like the way I did that, I think I must have added, I'm going to add a hint, this might sound weird, but I'm gonna add a little hint of red, because red and blue make
green.
Purple.
No. Wait, don't send Christine to the paint store.
Yellow and blue makes green. Okay, red and purple.
Don't send Christine to the paint store to fix the color.
Worry or not after today. No way.
You know, that was a quick.
I can do your budgeting and your
See, and I can't do that.
Just don't let her count the money.
Yeah,
Al knows. Don't let me count
the money. There's certain secrets.
Yeah.
That's funny. So you can see here, so I put a little bit of red in there, and what this does is made a, that's like a different type of a gray. Because gray doesn't mean just black and white. Gray can mean, you know, a warm gray, cool grays. But this one you can see, it just added a little interest, a little different color here, which I like that. And we are going to have red on the stitching on the ball, so if it, even though it's not red on the buildings, which you could even do that
and
too,
they're called seams on the baseball,
seams in this, is yeah. it stitching there too or no
just seams,
just seams,
yeah,
the seams on the ball.
Yeah,
okay, so what's laces? Oh, that's football.
Yeah,
laces out,
we'll talk football another time.
Yeah.
You got a couple baseball stories out of me, so.
Yeah, so Forest Field, talking about Forest Field, my hobby Jono went there, of course, when he was a kid. And
so did I.
He still has two original cardboard popcorn boxes. Back in the day, the cardboard boxes.
Yeah, I remember them. Yeah, he has them.
Forest Field.
Wow.
He could tell you what game he was there with, you know, Tommy Masterson and
Jono's the best.
Yeah, so he still has, I mean, when they were kids, he had them stapled to his wall.
Oh, that's cool.
So there are like some staple marks in them, I think. But he still has that. And he was actually asked by the Pittsburgh Pirates commissioned Jono. He has two big metal pieces, the Roberto Clemente and Maz painting that Jono did on metal at the main.
What an honor for Jono.
The main, what is it called?
Entrance?
Main lobby area, main floor, I think around home plate. They're right at a bench. They'll be on permanent display, his name's there, which is really cool. So for him growing up loving baseball and playing baseball to having his artwork down there at the ballpark is,
that is
very
amazing.
Special, and he's just very honored for that. And there are other great artists down there too, not just Jono's, but he does have that one little spot down there. So that's kind of neat. And so let's see. So what I did, you could see I added a little bit of red and made sort of like a purple gray. And you can get just variations. You can kind of play around with it. And I did
Do
not,
I start with white then and then add those to it? Or
always start with a lighter color because when you introduce
the darker. That's what I thought you
darker,
taught me, so
yeah.
I'm trying to. And then the red and the blue, I put that.
You can see where the this
Yours
one,
looks great.
This has a little hint. And I think I didn't do that too much on the design, but I think we're going to introduce just a little bit of red here and there on the buildings to repeat the colors on the stitching. Because when you repeat a color in design, that's a nice thing to do too. So I'm just adding, you can see the little hints.
Can I use white and black for some of the gray?
You can use whatever you want, sure.
All right.
You can use brown, you can use green. When most people think of black and white makes a gray, but gray really is all across the board.
Yeah, you've taught me that, yeah.
Dull variations of that.
Can I use black and brown then, or?
You do whatever you want.
Well, I'm just throwing it out there, and you gave me permission, so.
No.
I will carry on.
The only thing you have to remember is you want the buildings to be darker than that horizon.
Yeah.
And you want them to be lighter, then we're going to make this. And this is going to be more black anyway, a softer black.
Oh, that part
and
will
that
be black?
Way, yes. If you look up in the design here. And this way, it makes the buildings look a little more distant because they're in the background. And then we're going to do that. So I am going to use my little, I'm going to use my brush on its side, the edge, just to do these little points here on this building. And we can always come in, you can always come in and clean it up again. Just want to get the base done. And then I'm just gonna take a tiny bit of red, and maybe where there would be some lights on the building. I didn't do this on the design, on the top, or just here and there, just to get a little touch. I think I like the red in there since we have it on the ball. And again, it's just a matter of like when you're working on something, you just look back at it, come back. You can, you know, add things. You can make things darker, lighter. Just gonna get these little points. I think I have a little tiny liner brush that I need for these points on this building.
Oh, that small pointy one. Whoa. Hey.
That's my mother calling. Sorry.
Aww.
Hi, Mom.
That's okay.
Hi, Mom.
Yeah.
She'd be like, what were you doing?
I know.
I was painting.
It wasn't on my calendar. I have to give my mother a calendar every
Aww.
Month of what I have to do. And it wasn't on my calendar
Uh-oh.
That I was coming here. So.
That's
oh,
okay.
My goodness.
And then she won't be worried when you don't answer.
No,
right? Okay.
She knows I'm working.
Hey, we're glad you could make it on a work day.
Yeah. I'm a fat cat. I'm a fat cat. All right.
Well, you said it. I didn't.
Yes, I'm a fat cat.
All right.
So just tune in and hear this.
Okay, so the next thing I'm doing is I'm still using that same half-inch flat brush, and I'm doing the seats, the stands, and I'm kind of just outlining with my brush, and then I'm going to pull in a little bit of like brown and different colors in it, so it's a softer black, not necessarily a harsh black. And I want you to see, we're not painting the people in the crowd, but if you do a little variation of the colors like this, I'll show you. Throw a little bit of brown, you can even throw a little bit of that red, and just kind of mix it in with the black. It's just a different tone, different color on the stands that might just give that little hint that there's something else there other than just the seats. You can see if it shows up as good on the camera or not. I can add a little bit of white in there too. And you can see I just kind of smushed some little different colors in there.
I like that smush there.
Smushing, yes.
That's an
we
official,
understand.
An official artist
smush. It is.
Term.
It is now.
Yes.
You're just looking
Maria's
really good.
Maria's Ideas the Paints Dictionary.
Yeah. And then so
it's approved.
This section, this is all the black or kind of gray, brown.
Okay.
And that's coming around here. And then I even have a little bit, I guess there would be maybe some green on there's the wall or whatever.
Well, not really on the wall, but.
But like, you know, there's like the whatever that is going around. You could tell I go to baseball games. I love the baseball games, but I just kind of go to eat and just watch. I watch
oh,
a little
yeah.
bit.
I love to
people
eat.
Watch and.
Yeah.
Yeah, just fun.
There's plenty to watch.
Yeah. And
they do play ball on the field, yeah. So you can look every once in a while.
And then this, I'm just kind of pulling. I'm not worried about it really being perfectly straight. This is a very loose style that we're doing here.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and then just the little points here of, now this part up here, there's a little bit of the sky popping through. And then we have, I use my little quarter inch brush for that light. I think I'm gonna put another light in there. I don't know if it would be that close to that one, but I'm gonna put another one in there. So you can see I have all this. I can pick out some other spots if I want to on the buildings. I like how you did yours. They look really nice.
Oh,
different color. No, it looks really good. And then, but I'm gonna keep moving here. I'm gonna work on the field. So I'm gonna do the green section. Now, when I paint this green section, the field, they usually cut like patterns in it.
Yeah.
And we have that little bit of the lines in the pattern. So what I did was imagine these lines, they're going to what would be referred to as a vanishing point. Well, that vanishing point is right about in between these two buildings, right kind of here. So if you could imagine as you go to paint those lines, just use that as a reference point.
Well, on the field, it usually looks light green and dark green.
Right. So what we're going to do,
that helps.
Yes. So I'm starting with the dark green, and I'm going to mix.
I didn't mean to get technical.
No, that's good. Now this green I feel like is a little bit too bright. So what should I add to the green to tone it down just a little
yellow.
Bit? We don't have yellow.
Oh.
Well, that would be great if we had yellow.
You got me trained from before.
So we're going to add.
Our palette's different.
We're going to add red, which is the opposite of green on the color wheel. And by adding red, it just tones. You can see it just a little more of a natural green. Just a hint. If you add too much, then go back to the green. And what we're doing is in this, we're painting this section here. So now I actually need a little bit more. So I took that green and I just took the corner of my brush and I put that. So you can just see it just makes it a little more like a foresty green. And then
what did you combine with that?
A tiny bit of red.
Just red. Just a little.
It's the opposite.
Very little, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then what I'm going to do is
bring
that in. Okay, and then I'm gonna pull that around. That is this section here. Okay. And then I'll fill that in. So I'm doing the dark green first, and then I will mix a lighter green. And yellow would be a good choice to add to make the lighter, but we don't have yellow in our palette. So we're gonna just add white to make it lighter. So let's see, this is all green, the darker. We don't have it down in here. And then we have it, this is green. And you can refer to the picture too, Christine, if that helps you too. And then mix my green again. So this way, we want that darker base, and then we'll come in with a lighter green for the stripes. So how do they do that? They just go different directions.
They cut one way, then they cut the opposite way.
Cool.
You're very sharp there.
Okay, so we have to make sure when you paint this, you leave that little bit of this for the track or the spot where they. I just don't know my baseball terms. I'm sorry.
That's all right. Layman terms work.
Yeah. So you can see that's the darker. And then this. Now I'm just going to add a little bit of white. Now this is where you want to pay attention to that vanishing point. I'm going to mix. Yellow would have been prettier, but I can add. I'll add maybe a little bit of brown just so it's not so minty. So what I want to do, I'm going to use my quarter inch brush for the stripes because they're pretty much the good size.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do, this is the vanishing point in between these buildings, like kind of right in here. So if you can imagine where those lines begin and end. So if I'm coming this way, keep that vanishing point. And I'm going to do a little dot right there just so you could see it, and I can always paint over it. Or maybe that's like something red that somebody threw up in the air. And
whoa.
So anyway, I'm gonna come in like this, and I have my, you can see what I'm doing here? And I'm keeping that vanishing point as a reference, and I left the darker green, and I'm putting the lighter. Okay, and just like that. And you can space them further apart or however you want to do that. And then the vanishing point. So now they start to angle. Okay, because this one goes this way, and then that vanishing point again, if you drew a line, and that's, and this one goes this way. Just kind of keep that as a reference. Okay, so there are my lines on the field, and then I'm going to mix a little bit of red and brown and white and get that field. I'm gonna just move along now, guys.
Yeah,
okay,
no, move
just
along.
To get this. And I'm gonna get the field, the dirt, get that in there. And I'm gonna paint the ball and our little people. We're gonna paint like little carrots. You'll see, they're just like little carrots. I know it sounds funny, and I cannot take credit for the term, but I remember seeing some very eccentric artist. He was doing watercolors, I think, one time years ago. I saw him on TV, and he referred to the people. He's like, we're gonna paint carrots. I'm like, what is he talking about? And I'm like, I never forgot that. It was the funniest thing, but it works.
Yeah.
You'll see. And then this is the field. This is brown here. Okay. All right. And then we'll add our guys to that. All right, so I'm going to work on the ball. So for the baseball, I'm using the round, curved filbert, half inch filbert. Now this, kind of like we did the sky, we're going to work kind of quickly so that we can blend. And I'm putting this white right on the, ooh, got some blue in there, right on the baseball. So what I'm doing is I'm moving this white, got some blue in there, moving this white around the baseball. And when I'm cutting in, now this is where we want to try to clean up those edges right here. Same as that other technique. We're laying that brush down and pushing those bristles out to where they find that same point, and then just pull it around.
Okay.
And that should clean it up pretty nice. And to keep your hands steady, kind of hold your breath while you're doing it.
Uh-huh.
And if you can go a little quicker with the brush stroke, it will be usually a nice, a cleaner line. So I'm kind of coming around. Now the reason I'm kind of piling this paint on here, you'll see I really want this to blend. We want a shadow on the ball, but we also want the highlight.
Wow,
right?
You're getting deep, a little shadow.
Yeah,
there.
And we want this right underneath here. We want to keep that white. Keep it nice and white, because that's like a little bit of a reflection that makes it look more round. If we just took that shadow all the way down, it would not look as round, as like dimensional. So let's see, get that here. And this, might have to play with this a little bit, but I think that looks pretty good. Now, this is still wet. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm taking a little bit of the black, and I'm making that little bit of a gray again, and I am adding a hint, a tiny, tiny bit of red, so that it makes a pretty, kind of almost like a lavender gray.
Whoa.
All right, so some paint was flying there. A little bit of a lavender gray, and I'm putting this, now you can see I'm leaving this white right here. And I'm putting this shadow. See how I'm leaving that little bit of white under there?
Mm-hmm.
And then while this is still wet, I did this brush stroke, I'm going to blend it out. I'm taking some of that extra paint off of my palette, and I'm doing this with it. And just pulling it up and around. And then I will take the extra off of my paper towel again, so that I'm just using that. Now I'm gonna rinse my brush and add white back in here to blend it. So we just have that little, we want it to be the whitest on the left side. That's our light source. And I may have to add a little bit more white as it dries. So you can see a little bit of that white. And it doesn't have to be a very crisp line where that white is remaining, but just give it some white. So that makes that ball look, gives it a little bit more dimension there. I'm gonna put a tiny bit more right down in here. And then I'm gonna let that dry. And we'll do the stitches. Or the seams, right? The seams. So I've added, just wanted a little bit darker. I've added the different, the blues and the reds. I'm just kind of modeling the paint, the brush strokes, the like moving that paint around. Okay, so for the, let's see. So now, the seams, I'm going to take red, but I want it to be dark red, just for the seam, because it's a seam and it would be little, you know, deeper in there. And I'm going to grab this little liner brush. I can still see where that line is, and I'm just going to come in just like that. It's easier if you do one big stroke like this, if you're a little hesitant or don't feel as comfortable, then you can just do something like that, like little dashes. Which is also fine because the seams kind of have that vibe going anyway. And you can see their seam. And then we will take the red and then come this way. And just if you start out here and pull toward, then you'll get a nice, like a little, you have a little bit thicker out there, which I guess it typically, I think, kind of looks like that, where that with that thread or whatever, is it like some kind of thread, like what, I don't know, whatever they use to,
I think it's thread,
threads kind of thread,
looks like a thread.
Yeah, now oops, that one got a little chubby. You can always, once it dries, you can always fix things, but when we paint this in our styles, we're kind of, I think it's just a little looser fun. It's professional looking, I think, but yet we're not trying to win, you know, an award or put it in a museum or anything. Yeah. We're having fun, so have fun with it. A little more expressive with it, and you can see I'm just kind of coming around. And the seams also, if you keep this in mind, as they come under here, where that shadow is, they should be a little darker, because again, that light is not hitting them. And I feel like this needs to be a little darker in here. Are they red still? I don't know. When you see baseballs, they always
red.
Think of them red, are they?
No, you think of them as white. The red seams are
reds,
red.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're
red.
Always red.
Always still?
They were
okay.
Hand sewn years ago,
yeah,
with a leather ball.
Yeah.
And now they're all machined. And
is it still leather?
Yes.
Okay. I feel like
I think it's cow leather.
Huh. Okay.
Hmm.
We might have to go to faux leather someday.
Vegan leather.
Vegan.
Whoa.
Vegan baseball. Oh, yeah. All right. Okay, there we go. So I have them. Mine look, they're kind of chubby, but, you know, whatever. They're all right, I guess. I think this needs, and just little spots where if you need a little bit more red or the black, just add that in there. I think my ball might need a little help here and there, but I'm going to work on my little people. All right. So, oh, we can't forget this, the swooshy things. All right. Oh, I just stuck my pickle in the water. I'm sorry.
All right. We're having too much fun.
Yeah. So I have the ball, but we got that little swish, the swish line. So what I'm going to do is I'm using my little filbert, the little filbert one, and I'm starting. I'm going to do these first. We're starting up here, and I'm kind of looking ahead to see which direction they're going to go. I'm going to kind of end down here. We're starting and just really quick to get that tail. You can see I just pushed it down and lift up. So I did three of those, and I would do a couple this way, just like that. Okay. And then our birds in the clouds. And our little people. So I'm going to stick black on my little liner. And like Alan said when he was a kid, just do like little, kind of like a little M or a little V.
Yeah, it's like an M.
A little bird.
Yeah.
It just, again, it just
a little
adds
spread
a little,
out.
Yeah, yeah, it just adds a little interest up there.
I can't wait till I get to that.
Yeah, and then for the people.
I'm still planting grass.
Yeah. So I'm going to see if I can get this right. And I might have to, well, I was going to say, I might have to add a little bit of a lighter line on here. But I think we can see it enough. So I'm going to take my black, because these guys are just a silhouette little guy. So I'm going to see if I get this right. This is the batter. So I'm going to put a little, I'm going to show you real close. I'll do it on the plate too, up close to show you. These are our little carrot people. So you're going to do a little dot, and then you're going to paint a little wiggle, like a little carrot. Okay.
Dot.
Yeah, you see that? Like it looks like a little carrot.
Okay. Yeah.
And then you can add a little, another little leg if you want. You can put arms like it just looks like a little person.
Ah, that is so cool. I didn't know that.
Just a little dot. So I need my little, my batter guy here. Maybe have it look like that. See how his bat is sticking out? Okay, and then I have a little catcher is back here. Pitcher, right? Pitcher,
yes.
On the pitching mound. Okay.
Yes.
Oh, I got three so far.
You're getting them. You're doing great. I'm glad you studied.
And then, I don't know who this guy is. What's
We're
this
at?
Guy over here?
He would be third base.
Third base, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then in the middle would be second base,
oh,
if you go to the
first
left.
First base over here.
Yes.
So just paint your little character.
Then there'd be
people.
Shortstop between second base and...
In second base is, I lost my second base. It's like over here somewhere, huh? Like in here somewhere?
Yes.
All right, we'll put, so bases are loaded.
Well, you need runners then.
Yeah. Well, you can add your little players anywhere you choose. But I'm just going to do this, and I'm going to put somebody out here. All right. So that's all. They're just like little. They're just here and there. I do feel like this brown area is a little dark, so I can highlight that. But overall, I mean, we have, I think, you know, it's done. I think it needs a little... You can go back in, you can highlight some little things like this, but the main body of the painting is good. You can add some little shadows or little hints of darker black or blue just to pick out the shapes of the buildings, but I think I got everything in there. And then
yeah.
I feel like the grass might need a little, you know, as it dries, I'll go in and highlight and again a little bit too. And like this cloud, you could see how once it dried, I can add that little bit of white. So with your working with acrylics, you have to let areas dry, and then you just go back in and you can pick out, you can add shadows or highlights, and that's it.
Oh, I
so,
need a picture.
Yeah, so we're gonna let these guys finish up.
Mm-hmm.
They look really good. We'll come back with the finished paintings, okay? So we're going to reveal our paintings out of the park. You guys did it fabulous.
Out of the park is
fabulous.
Done.
What's up with the ball, Alan?
I got too bold.
I like it. Hey,
it's a little abstract baseball.
There's no rules here.
According to the talking machine, I went off the rails.
I like it.
I didn't blend it.
It was okay. This was a lot of fun.
Yeah,
really
you did
myself.
Great.
And I
Thanks
had
job.
I had seam difficulty.
That's okay.
Called too much paint.
Yeah, but you were good at playing
it.
Not maybe painting it as
yeah.
much more
it's experience
playing.
It's been a struggle. It's
it was
been
very
a struggle.
Good. Very good job. Thank you so
Thanks
much.
To you.
Christine's
it's so fun.
Great.
Thank you, co-producer, co-host.
Right, look at me, guys.
All right.
Awesome. Maria.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. All right,
okay.
Cool.
Okay, and then, so our next episode is episode 9, and this is Walk in the Park. Is that what I call it? Nature, oh, I'm sorry. I take that back. Nature Walk.
Okay.
So I figured September, kind of getting into fall, some fall leaves, and we have our two little people that we paint, our little carrots. We're gonna paint our little carrot people and add some little arms and legs on them. So that's going to be next episode. And it's just gonna be the two of us, Alan. Just me and you.
Just the two
of
us.
This is a little bit more involved.
Well, you can let me paint birds. You can see I do the birds
you
pretty
do birds
well.
Very well.
Very well.
The
yeah.
people, forget them.
Yeah.
No, it's good.
Little carrots.
And the seams. I never hold a baseball that looked like that.
It looks good.
Add another feather to your cat.
Yeah.
It looks like rope licorice.
Oh.
Which sounds really good.
Yeah.
Like
that. Yeah.
Very good. All right, guys. Thank you so much. See you next time.